at San Francisco, frankly, is an Italian town. And the city was built on immigrants coming in and staying and leaving their imprint. And I don't think anyone did it as handsomely as has been the case with people who originated in Italy and who immigrated from Italy.
Some of my parents and longest standing friends in San Francisco are the Italians. My first assignment in San Francisco Police Department was to the North Beach Station, certainly working all the North Beach festivals and the Columbus Day parades, now the Italian Heritage Day parades, all the tables out. My high school job was working for the Tonellis. So I don't know if I'm ever going to be ever successful were it not for the Italians in San Francisco.
Those contributions were made in virtually every area of life in this city, from politics, where I was, to sports, business, literature, the arts, education, and religion. Because Italian Americans and Italians from the old country, as we say, were important leaders in each of those areas.
The 36th and the 37th mayors of this great city were both Italian Americans. The one and only Joe Alioto, who brought a kind of vision for this city that excited everyone in this city. He was the quintessential Italian man. He loved the opera. He could sing it. He played the violin. He was a brilliant lawyer known throughout this country as one of the best antitrust lawyers.
Joe Alioto, absolutely one of the most indigenous, colorful mayors ever in the history of San Francisco. So incredibly dressed, so articulate, and so interesting and funny. One of his great lines was, when in a contest with another person running for mayor, that person condemned Joe Alioto for utilizing the talents of his family and giving his relatives jobs. And when Alioto got up to speak, he said so politely, "I'm very pleased that my opponent has described what I do in selecting the people that I select. Just be assured, as my opponent said, when she runs and wins, she will not hire any of her relatives. I won't hire any of her relatives either."
The very famous saying by Mayor Alioto, when he reassured anybody whenever there was a bad article in the newspaper, he was saying, "It's in the paper one day, and then the next day we wrap the fish with that paper." I loved Mayor Moscone. He was the father of my best friend in high school sweetheart, Rebecca Moscone. So we used to be in the Moscone house all through high school and when George was the mayor. And I think to say that he moved San Francisco forward like no other mayor ever and was so proud of his Italian heritage. And unfortunately, we lost him way too soon.
You instantly think of George Moscone, who was assassinated in his capacity as mayor. However, he had a profound effect on the city. The whole business of diversity and the emphasis on women and gays and African Americans and Asians in the delivery system comes out of the Moscone years of being the mayor, and he was only the mayor for 3 years before he was assassinated.
Angelo was one of those people. First of all, he came to this country like my mother and father did, as an immigrant seeking opportunity, clearly, to participate in American life, and came from a somewhat humble beginning as a washer, window washer, who joined with the labor movement to improve the strength of working people, and was very successful at that, and then moved into a bigger kind of business in his insurance. Rose to the top in the insurance business, just as he had in the labor movement, by being the kind of honest, personable, productive man that all of us knew him.
When I was first in San Francisco, we had an Italian, Mayor Angelo J. Rossi. We had Italian supervisors, Dr. Ottola, Alphonse Zerpoli. Dr. Ottola's son, George Moscone, was a supervisor, a senator, and the mayor. Joe Aliotto was the mayor. His daughter was a member of the Board of Supervisors. They had a strong political influence. Two Italian clubs, the Columbus Civic Club and the Italian Catholic Federation.
My grandmother was still alive from my mother's side. We would go to North Beach to go shopping. And then, you know, we spoke some Italian. And we as the youngsters would begin embarrassed because the other children would make fun of us, and they would mock us when we spoke Italian with our parents. And so you would end up going to your parents and saying, don't speak Italian in front of these other people because they laugh, they make fun of us. Being Italian was not normal, or being Italian was something to be ashamed of or embarrassed about. When we were migrating from Italy, we were coming to do manual labor. Now the migration in large is intellectual in approach, with the exception of much of what happens in terms of Central America, because so many people are migrating from there, not only for intellectual pursuit, but obviously for the economic advantage of work and jobs in San Francisco, in the United States, and having the ability to send money back to family in Mexico. So I think that the Italian community has done very well in America. I think the Italian culture of Italy, as it has been translated in the United States by the American Italian or the Italian American, has had a tremendous impact on American culture, especially in major urban areas. But I think everything from agriculture in particular, to food processing industry, manufacturing, waste management. I mean, just all of the things that we did, because those were the jobs that were available, those were the things that we knew how to do.
People of Italy and people of Italian descent, a hearty congratulations in this year of Italian culture. We are the beneficiaries of that magnificent culture. This year we celebrate yours, and I join with everyone of Greek descent as well in wishing you a magnificent year, because we are the beneficiaries of your contributions, not only to our city, but to the world.